Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the Hudson Lakefront Band Shell. And in front of you, you see two ensembles. One of them is the St. Croix Valley Community Band. The other is the Twin Cities Trumpet Ensemble. And we are going to start with the Star Spangled Banner. So if you could please rise when you hear the snare roll and join us in the singing of them.
Welcome to the 7th RiverFest celebration. My name is Judy Freund, and on behalf of the Planning Committee, we are so grateful that you are able to join us on this very warm evening. RiverFest is called Party with a Purpose, and tonight we will be partying as we listen to this wonderful music presented to us by this community band. And we've had the opportunity to visit with nonprofits and to hear about their mission and their purpose in lifting up and supporting our community and our beautiful river. I am hoping you all have a copy of the agenda, the itinerary for RiverFest, because I want me to remind you that we're only halfway through. There are events on your program happening tomorrow, Friday. There are events happening Saturday, including a Native American singing, dancing, drumming event in the afternoon, preceded by lacrosse. And in the evening, we really want to call your attention to an event called Woodland Echoes. Again, it'll be a taste of Native American foods, and it'll be more singing, dancing, and an extravaganza. That one is by ticket. We will be coming through the audience and offering some tickets for sale, or as well, you can visit our booth. The program also contains the names of our many sponsors and our many partners. We are grateful for the support that they've lended to RiverFest. In particular, we'd like to give a shout out to our event sponsor, Norlay. They're the folks that are offering you that delicious root beer this evening. I'd like to call to welcome you on behalf of Norlay, Keith Funk.
I'd like to thank the community and the RiverFest organization for allowing us to be a sponsor. We've been in the community since about 1947. We've been with the community since 1947. So, what? Higher? Can you hear me now? No? How about now? All right. Thank you. Appreciate it. We've been around since about 1947. We've been a big part of the community. We basically make equipment that keeps things cold. So we've got a factory outside the city limits, and we got a corporate office just down the street. And one of the things we look forward to is sponsoring this event. We look forward to having volunteers go out, and we had an abundance of volunteers that help clean up the river. That's always an exciting thing for our team. And we're fortunate enough to have an organization that allows us to get involved in the community and encourage us. It gives us the flexibility to do things like this. So again, thank you. And in the spirit of keeping things cold, we have cold root beer back there. So come back and get you some. Thanks.
Thank you.
Thanks, Keith, and again, a big hand for Norley. Thank you so much. And again, let me remind you, the list of sponsors are on the program sheet for RiverFest, as well as our partners. With that, I'm going to turn it back over to this wonderful orchestra to enjoy the rest of the evening. Again, thank you all for coming.
Thank you.
summertime when the living is easy, fish are jumping and the water is high. George Gershwin from his operetta and wonderful, wonderful music featuring Denny McGinn. Denny McGinn hails from the Afton, Minnesota area, just right across the river. As you can see, we are a community group. We hail from all over the place, but we share one thing in common. We love good music, we love community, and we love serving our region, no matter what side of the river it's on. So we welcome you to sit back and enjoy summertime. We wait for this all year, so just let that happen all over you.
Thank you. you.
Thank you. Oh. Well, everybody knows that trumpet players are supposed to play fanfares. You got it. We are very, very happy to be here. We are the Twin Cities Trumpet Ensemble, and having this joint concert with the community band is just a thrill for us. We enjoy so much playing with community groups. That first fanfare was indeed called the Hoffman Fanfare, written by a British composer named Malcolm Arnold. We're going to play another British piece for you. This is, the real title is called the Colonel Bogey March. But many people first were acquainted with this when Bridge on the River Kwai came out as a movie. And so, anyway, here is our version, inspired by that movie production, our version of Colonel Bogey. Oh, by the way, let's see, we have to tune up. So we're playing this on the smallest trumpets possible, mainly mouthpieces. So we have to tune them all up there. Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, everyone. Again, my name is Kris Tank, and I'm a former band director here at Hudson High School and in South Washington County, and now I'm out in the corporate world trying to do wonderful things there as well. But I do still get the privilege of sharing music with both of these ensembles, and part of the Twin Cities Trumpet Ensemble. And the director you just saw there, that is Mr. James Alcott, and he's been running this ensemble for 3 years about. So thank you guys for all being here. Let's give them a big hand. And of course, for keeping this band going for many, many years, over 20 years, I think 25 or better, that's Dr. Kris Tjornehoj from UWRF. Please give her a wonderful big hand. And at this time, we're going to play a really fun little march, which comes from an opera. And it's in a nice swingy 6/8 time, and we invite any kids who would like to dance around, that would be wonderful as well. This is called Funiculi Funicula.
Wrote this piece. This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the wood. New York Islands. And fill in all the words and sing along.
Connie, I'm glad you printed that for me. Okay, I'm going to give you four and you're it. Okay? One, two, three, up.
Thank you.
classic Shenandoah. Originally, that arrangement was for a vocal group, but it fit so well with trumpets, you just couldn't resist arranging it for the ensemble. We'd like to play another standard of American repertory. I'm not going to even announce it. You'll hear it as soon as you, and know it as soon as you hear it. So prepare. Star Wars, now you do. What a great piece. Fun arrangement. We're going to do one more piece before we give it back entirely to the band. This time we're going to have the band play with us and probably the most recognized piece for multiple trumpets there is. And this one's by Leroy Anderson. And this is our version of Bugler's Holiday. Thank you.
Thank you.
One thing that's really challenging playing a brass instrument, especially, is when it changes into a slide instrument, like it slides all over your mouth. There are slide trumpets, by the way. This is a salute to American jazz. I hope you enjoy some of the medley, this whole medley of some of the tunes you will recognize.
Thank you.
RiverFest, I would like to invite all young people up. That last piece of music we just did was a tribute, yeah, you're young at heart, tribute to American jazz. And where did the jazz come from? It originated all the cultures mixing in New Orleans and coming up the river. And aren't we celebrating the river here tonight and RiverFest? So a lot of that music. And then the last piece that was played was called Birdland. But they meant Charlie Bird, a saxophonist. But you can pretend it's the birds that fly in the sky, because it's our creativity and imagination that we're going to be dealing with. So I have a friend named Andreas, and he was born in Colombia, and then he moved at 7 years old to Florida. And Andreas is going to come up and do a little call and response for you. So during this little segment, you can take river sticks that we've picked up from the river, and we're going to go out by these canoes and kayaks. We're going to make a little music. And what do you think? Anybody who's young or young at heart, please join us. Thank you for your participation. You can take those river sticks, and if they've been cleaned, they've been, everything you can do can be a percussion instrument. You go home now and you try it with pots and pans. And then you go into the bathroom and then you use the bathtub. But we don't even play on the canoes and kayaks till the concert's over now. So how cool is that? So make music everywhere you can. It fills your soul and your spirit. So this is what we're all about. So again, you can take river sticks back to you and you can play on the grass, because we would like to honor all those who have served in any of our armed forces to protect our country and to make our world a better place. Let's start, please. Salute to America's finest. Thank you.
trumpet players, we're always looking for new music, especially old fanfares. In the last couple of months, we've been contacted by people in England who were showing us some of the fanfares that were used for coronations and weddings and so forth. So we'd like to play two fanfares for you, and I'll talk about the second one after we do the first. But this first one is actually a fanfare that was written for 1937, George VI, his coronation. It was used again in 1952 for Queen Elizabeth. So here is the fanfare that opened up them walking into Westminster at the beginning of the coronation ceremony. Ceremony in Delhi, India, for the coronation of the Emperor of India, of course, who was the English king at that time. And it was a huge two-week celebration with Maharajas coming from all over India with their elephants and their golden tusks and their ladies in all the emeralds. There was a huge, huge amount of money that they exhibited. It was absolutely extravagant. This particular fanfare opened up that ceremony, and it's called Flourish for Trumpets by C.V. Stanford.
Thank you.
You don't hear too many fanfares like that, boy. We'd like to close our segment with a good old American march. A guy named Henry Fillmore, who wrote a lot of marches, very, very popular, 1930s, 1940s. And this is one of his most popular. And this is our version of Henry Fillmore's His Honor. Forgot to mention something before we get going here, that we have several different kinds of trumpets back there. You may have noticed, besides the regular B flat, let's see, Scott, can you hold up? That's a regular B flat there, but we have what we call a piccolo trumpet, which is one half the size over there, and then we have the flugelhorns. They look really different, and then we have a C trumpet here, and who's got the bass trumpet? Is your bass trumpet flying around tonight? Well, anyway, there's a trumpet that's twice the size. Anyway, so we play with a lot of different kinds of trumpets to get different kinds of sounds. I was going to introduce that before His Honor, but my mistake, I will turn the microphone back over.
Journey, a tribute to Journey. Don't stop believing. We hope that you'll sing along, and it's a good tune to dance to.
Thank you.
I'd like to thank you for coming, and on behalf of RiverFest, I would love to thank the committee members who put together an entire week of things that help us support and respect our environment and our river and help in cleanup. And I'd like to highlight that on Saturday, here from 10 to 4, there is a plethora of Native American dancers and people and programming here, and then also in the evening at Willow River. So please come, please learn, please share. And we hope to see you again next year. We're going to end with Stars and Stripes forever. Thank you.
Thank you. I don't think we need an encore. We've had enough fun.